Hey, what's up, guys? So just hanging out here. Just hanging out here with my buddy. And I want to share with you an inspiring story that I learned today from one of my clients who just came on board to get some help with branding his business and taking it to the next level. And it was crazy because his story just resonated with me in so many different levels. So back in the days, about 13 years old, a few years back, and this kid moves into the neighborhood from Brooklyn, and he's got this terrible haircut. So he comes to my buddy and he goes, dude, you think you can help me out with this? I just got a busted haircut. So the kid didn't know anything about hair at all, cutting hair, whatever. And he took his dog's cutting shears. And he was like, let me see what I can do. So he winds up giving this kid a fade, and it actually looks awesome. So the kid gets all stoked, and he's like, oh my God, thank you so much. So my client was like, dude, I think I'm onto something here. So he starts cutting hair. So all his friends from high school start coming over, his brother's friends from high school start coming over, and he starts cutting hair like crazy in his garage. And all of a sudden, he was like, all right, dude, I gotta get out there and get some real experience. So he goes to this local shop, and this guy, Joe, hires him, and basically, that day, literally starts cutting hair that day. And stayed with this guy, Joe, for 5 years. And there was this other guy that worked for Joe, and a few months after my client started working, he fires the guy. He's like, listen, we're cutting down, blah, 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 whatever the case. So that guy goes out and he starts his own shop, right? So my client's there for 5 years, building his experience, you know, getting a lot of work under his belt, but he doesn't have a barber's license. So after 5 years, Joe goes and fires him cold turkey, walks into work one day and he's like, sorry, you gotta go. I'm scared. I don't wanna get in trouble. And when you don't have a license to do certain work, you know, that's the cost of doing business, right? So so he just didn't understand it because he thought he built up such a friendship with Joe and that was it. But that was the kick in the rear end that my client needed. So he went back to his garage and he starts cutting hair like crazy. And now he's starting to make some serious cash. And he was saying that like in the winter time it was like 28 degrees and he's out there with a bubble jacket and he's cutting hair, and in the summertime he's barely got nothing on, he's sweating and he's cutting hair, and he starts to make a considerable bit amount of money. So let me rewind for a sec. So before he started this, you know, when he was a kid, he sat down with his mom one day and his mom was like, so what do you want to do with your life? And he was like, dude, honestly, I really want to cut hair, I really enjoy it. She was like, well, then you got to make a business out of it. And sure enough, I just told the story, he made a hell of a business out of it. So one day he's in the shop and in his garage and he's cutting his hair, cutting somebody's hair, and his buddy goes, dude, you gotta open up your own store. So he didn't have his license yet, so he was super scared to take the license because he was so scared of failing. And it was amazing because I resonated with that because I was terrible in school. I wasn't that good in school at all. And he finally got the courage to take the test. It took him 3 times, but eventually the 3rd time he passes it. So he's all pumped up and he goes out and he says, well, how the hell am I gonna get a store? So his buddy at the time had a nice Mercedes, big Mercedes. And he said, listen, we're gonna go out shopping for stores. I'm gonna drive you around in the back of my car. So, you know, makes it look like you're a big deal. And I was laughing because they were kids, you know, they didn't know any better. So they get in the back and he's driving around. They finally find this location and they walk in and his dad helps him out and they sign a lease and he opens up his first shop. So all of a sudden he's doing great. He's got processes in place. He's doing awesome. He finds out that the guy that he used to work with at Joe's shop that started his own spot was struggling. So he went to him and he was like, dude, why don't I just take over your shop? I'll buy it from you and we'll get this thing rocking. So sure enough, he buys that. So now he's got 2 locations. Within a couple years, he opens up 3 more locations. And now he's cranking. And now he's like, I wanna build this brand. I want to take this brand to the next level. But it was funny because in the beginning, his father always told him that he wouldn't be able to do it. That, you know, barbers don't make money, and, you know, he's never going to make money doing what he was doing. So he was destined to prove his dad wrong. So sure enough, a few years later, he opens up 5 locations. And now he's in the process of building it and taking it to a whole nother level. Forget what he said, but he was like, my best year I made close to $500,000. And I was like, wow, from cutting hair in your garage. I just found that story to be truly inspiring. And I wanted to share it with you because that's what makes America great. Because there's places in the world that you wouldn't have a chance in hell or opportunity to do what this kid did. And so now he's just killing it, and he's gonna open up several more stores in the near future. And so I wanted to share that with you because I want to know what your story is. Because these are the types of clients that I'm working with, and it's just amazing how motivating and passionate and inspirational these types of stories that I get to hear truly are. And that's why I get up in the morning and do what I do to help these entrepreneurs, because stories like that are powerful. And that's what makes America great.